Yo everyone, it's Meng, and yesterday I was in the middle of Hurricane Kirk here in France. If you're also in the hurricane, I heard about Milton also in the Florida. Be careful, take care of yourself. So yesterday I was not really ready for a video, but today I will do a video about Cacania. As you can see, I was very unlucky last time with Lucy P6 with 400 pulls. I did not lost the 50-50 for once. I was hoping to lost it, but I did not lost the 50-50, so got P6 Lucy for nothing. And I used 400 pulls and I don't have a lot for Cacania now. So I stick to my plan to skip her. I think I can do well without her. So she has empathy here. She's basically like a paladin. She's taking damage for her teammate. It's just like a cover ability. If you played Ragnarok Online, so it's like the Crusader skill devotion, but for the full party. Always active when her empathy is not full. And she can release her empathy here. For her buff and for her ultimate damage. So it's like a revenge strike. So yeah, very paladin-like kit to me at least. So yeah, I don't know why people compare her to Theri. So this is the ultimate releasing damage, 30% as Genesis. So damage amplification for the whole turn. Very good for burst teams. Very good. And this one can heal herself, so this is for her self-sustain, or she can use it to buff an ally depending on empathy, 300 flat attack and empathy value. So buffer, taking damage for others. She does not reduce damage, so that's one maybe of her downside. So she just the damage repartition is different with empathy, but does not reduce the incoming damage. Her portraits are also pretty good if you want her to survive better. The last one is the one you want if you want to maximize the damage for raids. It's for single target only her ultimate, so from 30% to 45%, it's 50% increase. Is very good. Completely unnecessary because red now is very easy. But if that's one of your thing, big numbers, yeah, definitely very, very strong character for single target damage race and one turn burst. So I did build Semmelweis last time to showcase a free-to-play roguelike mode. And she's pretty good. I really like her design. She's one of my favorite, maybe my favorite design in this game, actually. I really like her ponytail style from the Echoes of the Mountain, the 1.6, patch 1.6 event. And I did clear a bulletin here, so this is where you will probably use Cacania the most, I think, if you have Windsong or Spathodia, especially Windsong. Windsong can do a lot of damage in only one turn. But this one was really easy with Lucy. But as you can see, I don't need Cacania to get triple S score, and there's no need to go beyond that. So I saw there's a leaderboard on Discord, but I think it's stupid. It's just a well showcase. It's not really a skill showcase to me. It's just a money showcase. So yeah, they're just punching bag at this point for raids for most veteran players like me. So yeah, not really worth pulling just for raids, I think. And the Cacania can also... Oh, I haven't done the daily for this. Cacania can also help in roguelike mode, but I did a free-to-play clear for roguelike mode, so I don't think you need her. She can help, but she's not needed. So I think that's the main dilemma with the new characters now. We have very strong, for veterans like me, we have very strong roster already. and all the new characters will only be a good quality update for the roster, but not very necessary. We can clear everything fine. The game difficulty did not increase that much compared to the power level of the characters. So if you want to save, I think this is the good time to save until maybe Anjonara. Anjonara will be a good power spike. So if you can get Anjonara, I think it's a good moment to get a good boost for your roster. But I think even Anjonara is capable. If you have Lucy and Villa, I think those two, they can clear everything now. And in the future too, so... And the rest is just pull for your favorites, do what you want, but there's no need to pull after meta in this game. Oh, this one is not that great. Oh, this one is good. It's for 47. yeah, you can just pull for characters you like after you build a good base, I think. So this is what I'm going to do. I'm gonna skip Cacania, and I hope Isolde will not kill me in my sleep. I have to tie her so she does not kill me in my sleep. But yeah, I will be P5 Isolde Cacania less account. So that will be weird. I've cleared this also. We got portraits for Lorelei. Very good. I think I will max Lorelei, I think. Her resonance. I really like her character, and I think she will be a good character to showcase since she's free to play. Everyone can get her. I think she's very strong because she can buff the team without using any AP, and I think this will be something I will look forward in future characters, because you want all the AP to go to your most valuable character. So basically the carry and the strongest buffer or debuffer, most of the time it's Villa, because she can give back Moxie and Yurika, so the AP is not completely wasted with Villa. And the other characters, you want them to just stay put and stay nice in the corner and give bonus some goodies for free, right? So yeah, this is maybe the best plan for the future. So this is my spreadsheet updated with L'Opéra, released yesterday. I think it was around the same time as Cacania in the global version. And I'm not really sure about her kit. I like to define characters based on which archetype team they fit in. And L'Opéra, she will fit in Burn and Bullet, I think, new archetype that is built around her. But she does not have a lot of characters that will benefit from it, at least right now. Maybe in the future, because we saw with Marcus, she was like a rank up card archetype. And she was not that great when she was released, but now she has a lot of support around this archetype. And a lot of older characters, Anani also got an upgrade in CN where she can upgrade all the cards in the hand for free every two turns, I think. She's crazy, so I think we can skip Mercuria probably if we just want to use Anani. So yeah, this is also a plan for the future. Wait for characters upgrades and see if you really really want to pull for the new characters, or just upgrade older ones who can also fit in the same role. So yeah, right now I'm skipping until Anjonara, and maybe probably will P5 her because she's the best partner for 37. I'm not really into her character. She's a singer though, so she has bonus points from being a singer, but yeah, I'm not completely sold, unlike Isolde. So we'll see, but yeah, probably P5 if I have the resources. So now I'm building, I'm saving right now, and if I want to, I'll be able to P5 on Jonara. So this is it for me. I'm skipping Cacania, Dr. Cacania, and if you're pulling for her, good luck. She's very good, and I think a lot of you need therapy from a psychoanalyst like her. But I think I'm doing fine. I'm managing my gambling addiction okay. I think I don't need a therapy for now. And see you next time. Ciao, ciao.